little scientists. I'm Professor Bill Tyson, and together we're gonna know different forms of science. In our last meeting, we talked about the physical transformations of matter. Today, we're gonna talk about the temperature at which solid substances become liquid, and the liquid substances become gaseous. In nature, we find several types of substances in different states. For example, the oxygen we breathe is in the gaseous state. The water we drink is in the liquid state. And a metal fork we use to eat is in a solid state. But why are they in different states? If they are in an environment under the same temperature, we call this the fusion point and the boiling point. The boiling point is when a substance passes from the liquid to the gaseous state. It is called so because when the liquid is very hot, it starts to make bubbles, or boiling. Each chemical element has its property, its fusion point and boiling point, which means any specific temperature changes the state of matter of a solid, liquid, or gaseous substance. The water, for example. For it to turn ice, it must be at the temperature of 0 degrees Celsius. This temperature is then the fusion point of the water. For the water to turn into gas, must be at the temperature of 100 degrees Celsius. And this temperature is the boiling point of the water. If a substance is found in nature in the gaseous state, it will need a much lower temperature to pass into the liquid state. The oxygen, for example, its fusion point is 218 degrees below zero, or 218 degrees negative. This is the temperature required for oxygen to turn liquid. And what about a substance that we find in nature in the solid state? What is the temperature to become liquid? Iron, for example, has its fusion point at 1538 degrees Celsius. Wow, that's pretty hot, huh? Just thinking of this heat has made me thirst. That's it for now. See you next time. Want to interest more kids in science? Share this video and become my patron.